We begin tonight with new details on the James and Michelle Butler double homicide.
Our Crystal Dominguez was the first to break this story. She joins us now live out of Claiborne County with the very latest and newest information. Crystal.
You guys, around 2 o'clock this afternoon, the Claiborne County Sheriff's Office held their second news conference of the week. At today's, they identified the male and female who were seen in the missing truck that belongs to the Butlers. Yesterday, the two were named persons of interest. Today, at least one of them is wanted for a crime. The Claiborne County Sheriff's Office identified the male seen in the picture as 33-year-old Adam Curtis Williams. He's described as a white male, average build. He has a scar below his left eye, two moles, one on his left cheek, and one above his left eye. He also has numerous tattoos all over his body and gauges in his ears. Officials tell us he's considered armed and dangerous. Right now, Adam Curtis Williams is facing a felony theft charge for allegedly stealing James and Michelle Butler's vehicle and driving it into Mexico. There's a warrant out for his arrest and a bond has been set at $1 million. Police also released the name of the woman who they say was in the truck with Williams. She's identified as Amanda Novere. We're told she's still just a person of interest in this case. James and Michelle Butler were from New Hampshire. They were staying on Padre Island in their camper while on their way to Florida. The family last spoke to them on October 16th and reported them missing days later. Sadly, their bodies were found buried south of Bob Hall Pier. Now, about 2 hours ago, I spoke with Deborah Van Loon, who is the sister of James Butler, and she tells me she learned of these latest developments about 20 minutes before the news conference. She also tells me she wants justice to be served. She says she can't believe how many lives have been destroyed, all because these people wanted to steal vehicles. She calls it horrific. In Claiborne County, Crystal Dominguez, Action 10 News.